Cratchit, Bob Cratchit.
Glenn, Poet of Jesus.
Glenn, are you paying attention to the reading?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. The reading of Christmas, let it begin.
Cardboard O is going around. Anyone in Cardboard O?
And you're ruining Christmas. God, damn it.
Anyway, Bob Cratchit. Of course, Scrooge wouldn't pay him very much, and it was Christmas, and he wouldn't let him off on Christmas Eve to go be with his family.
No,
and Tiny Tim, who could not walk and needed help. So anyway,
news to me.
Thanks for the crazy.
Are you reading the last bit again?
It's new to a lot of us.
So
Glenn and I love.
All of a sudden, Scrooge decides that, you know, he wants to make a difference. So here it is. So, Bob is pleading, right, Bob Cratchit? It's only once a year, sir, pleaded Bob, appearing from the tank. It shall not be repeated. I was making rather merry yesterday, sir. Now, I'll tell you what, my friend, said Scrooge. I am not going to stand this sort of thing any longer. Therefore, he continued, leaping from his stool and giving Bob such a dig in the waistcoat that he staggered back. And therefore, I am about to raise your salary. Bob trembled and got a little nearer to the ruler. He had a momentary idea of knocking Scrooge down with it, holding him, and calling to the people in the court for help and a straight waistcoat.
That's a straight coat. Come on.
Straight jacket.
Just a waistcoat. Yeah.
A Merry Christmas, Bob, said Scrooge, with an earnestness that could not be mistaken as he clapped him on the back. A merrier Christmas, Bob, my good fellow, than I have given you for many a year. I'll raise your salary and endeavor to assist your struggling family, and we shall discuss your affairs this very afternoon over a Christmas bowl of smoking bishop. Bob, make up the fires and buy another coal scuttle before you dot another I. Bob Cratchit. You'd think I was with
a 7-year-old, maybe.
Now, listen to this.
The 7-year-old just is so funny.
Man, you're ruining tradition here.
Now, listen to this.
You just like torturing
us. This goddamn thing.
Is that me? The same thing?
Or not. Scrooge was better than his word. He did it all and infinitely more. And to Tiny Tim, who did not die, he was a second father.
It's a real funny part of the story.
It is.
It's a comedy. You know it.
He became as good a friend, as good a master, and as good a man as the good old city knew, or any other good old city, town, or borough in the good old world. Some people laughed to see the alternation in him, but he let them laugh and little heeded them, for he was wise enough to know that nothing ever happened on this globe for good at which some people did not have their fill of laughter. Sit the fuck down. This is not very fair. And knowing that such as these would be blind anyway, he thought it quite as well.
Amen.
No.
Praise Jesus.
Sit the fuck down.
They should wrinkle up your eyes in grins, as have the malady in less attractive forms. His own heart laughed, and that was good enough for him. He had no further intercourse with
That's Lennon, my favorite part.
I'm sitting intercourse.
Every year.
He had no further intercourse with spirits.
Oh, shit.
But lived upon the total absence. abstinence principle ever afterwards. And it was always said of him that he knew how to keep Christmas well. If any man alive possessed the knowledge, may that be truly said of us, and all of us. And so, as Tiny Tim observed, God bless us, everyone.
Oh, okay.
Lovely.
That was lovely.
It was lovely. We all laughed at that.